Throughout aviation history, few aircraft have captured the imagination quite like the Northrop Grumman B-2 Spirit. This bat-winged behemoth, with its otherworldly silhouette and ghostly ability to slip undetected through the most sophisticated air defenses, represents the pinnacle of stealth technology. Born in the shadows of Cold War paranoia and nurtured by cutting-edge aerospace innovation, the B-2 emerged as a technological marvel that could deliver devastating firepower anywhere on the globe while remaining virtually invisible to enemy radar. From its first revealed glimpse in 1988, the B-2 Spirit has been shrouded in an aura of mystery and awe. Its smooth, seamless exterior conceals a complex network of radar-absorbing materials and electronic countermeasures, while its flying wing design allows it to achieve unprecedented levels of aerodynamic efficiency and stealth. With a price tag that made it pound for pound more valuable than gold, the B-2 has been both celebrated as an unparalleled strategic asset and criticized as an exorbitant Cold War relic. Yet from the skies over the Balkans to the deserts of Afghanistan and Iraq, this silent predator has proven its worth time and again. The genesis of the B-2 Spirit can be traced back to the tense geopolitical landscape of the 1970s. As the Cold War between the United States and the Soviet Union intensified, both superpowers raced to develop ever more advanced military technologies. The United States Air Force, in particular, was deeply concerned about the Soviet Union's increasingly sophisticated air defense systems, which threatened to neutralize America's existing bomber fleet. In 1979, the Air Force issued a request for a new long-range strategic bomber capable of penetrating these advanced air defenses. This aircraft, initially known as the Advanced Technology Bomber, or ATB, would need to combine extended range, heavy payload capacity, and most crucially, stealth technology, the ability to evade detection by radar and other sensors. The goal was to create a bomber that could penetrate Soviet airspace undetected, strike high-value targets, and return safely, all while maintaining the United States' strategic nuclear deterrent capability. The timing of this request coincided with significant advancements in stealth technology. Lockheed's pioneering work on the F-117 Nighthawk had demonstrated the potential of stealth in combat aircraft, but the Air Force needed a platform that could carry a much larger payload over intercontinental distances. In 1981, the U.S. Air Force awarded the ATB contract to Northrop Corporation. Northrop's experience with innovative aircraft designs positioned them well to take on this challenging project. The company assembled a team of the nation's top aerospace engineers and scientists, operating under unprecedented levels of secrecy. The development process was marked by extreme security measures. Engineers worked in isolated teams, often unaware of the full scope of the project. Components were acquired through a network of front companies to avoid arousing suspicion. Even the factory where the B-2 was built, Air Force Plant 42 in Palmdale, California, was heavily guarded and off-limits to unauthorized personnel. As work on the project continued throughout the 1980s, it faced significant political and budgetary challenges. Towards the end of the decade, with the Cold War beginning to wind down, there were increasing questions about the necessity of such an expensive weapon system. The original plan to produce 132 B-2s was repeatedly scaled back, eventually resulting in a total production run of just 21 aircraft. Despite delays and cost overruns, by the fall of 1988, the first B-2 Spirit, known as Air Vehicle 1 or AV-1, was complete. This new aircraft represented a pinnacle of aerospace engineering, seamlessly blending form and function to create a machine of unparalleled stealth and efficiency. At the heart of its design lay the flying wing concept, a tailless aircraft configuration, dating back to the 1940s, that integrated the wings and body into a single continuous structure. This revolutionary design offered several key advantages, including improved aerodynamic efficiency, a drastically reduced radar cross-section, and increased internal volume for fuel and payload. Remarkably, the B-2's lifting body design generated 89% of its total lift from the blended wing body shape, compared to about 50% for conventional aircraft of the time. The aircraft's dimensions underscored its unique design philosophy. With a wingspan stretching 172 feet and a length of just 69 feet, the B-2's unusual aspect ratio contributed significantly to its low radar profile and high lift-to-drag ratio. Standing at a height of 17 feet and boasting a wing area of 5,140 square feet, the B-2 cut an imposing figure on the tarmac. The leading edge of the wing was swept at a precise 33-degree angle, optimizing the aircraft for subsonic cruise efficiency while still allowing for a projected maximum speed of Mach 0.95 at 40,000 feet altitude. This impressive speed capability was complemented by the B-2's remarkable range. The aircraft was designed to maintain a cruise speed of Mach 0.85 for its entire 6,000 nautical mile unrefueled range, a testament to its aerodynamic efficiency and advanced propulsion system. Speaking of propulsion, the first B-2 was powered by four General Electric F118-GE-100 non-afterburning turbofan engines, each producing 17,300 pounds of thrust. These engines were ingeniously buried deep within the aircraft's body, with the inlets shielded by special S-shaped ducts lined with radar-absorbing materials. The stealth capabilities of the B-2 were perhaps its most defining feature. Its radar cross-section was estimated to be 0.1 square feet or less, equivalent to that of a small bird. This remarkable achievement was made possible by the aircraft's exterior design and materials. The skin of the aircraft was composed of advanced composite materials, including carbon fiber reinforced plastic and coated with radar absorbent materials. These materials could absorb up to 99% of incoming radar energy across a broad spectrum of frequencies. To further enhance its stealth characteristics, the aircraft's surface was maintained to extremely tight tolerances, with panel gaps no wider than 0.003 inches to prevent radar reflections. The B-2's stealth extended beyond its radar signature to include infrared suppression as well. The exhaust from its engines was cooled from about 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit to 200 degrees Fahrenheit and vented through narrow slits along the 172-foot trailing edge of the wing. This innovative design reduced the aircraft's infrared signature by a factor of 10 compared to conventional aircraft exhaust, making it extremely difficult to detect through heat-seeking systems. Controlling such an unconventional aircraft design presented unique challenges, which were met by the B-2's advanced fly-by-wire system. This technological marvel made up to 50 control surface adjustments per second to maintain stability. The aircraft used split rudders on the trailing edge of the wing for yaw control, while elevons provided pitch and roll control. These control surfaces accounted for about 20% of the wing's trailing edge area. Interestingly, the fly-by-wire system allowed the B-2 to have a static margin of negative 10%, meaning it was inherently unstable and thus more maneuverable than conventional stable aircraft of the era. Despite its large size and complex systems, the B-2 was designed to be operated by a crew of just two, seated side by side in a cockpit that showcased the aircraft's advanced capabilities. The cockpit featured six multifunction displays and two head-up displays, providing the crew with comprehensive situational awareness. For long-duration missions, comfort was key. The cockpit could be sealed and pressurized, allowing operation at altitudes up to 50,000 feet without pressure suits. Moreover, the aircraft was equipped with a toilet and a bed, allowing one crew member to rest while the other flew. The B-2's offensive capabilities were as impressive as its stealth features. Its weapons bay was designed to carry up to 40,000 pounds of ordnance, including a variety of conventional and nuclear weapons. For conventional missions, it was projected to carry a range of precision-guided munitions. In its nuclear role, the B-2 was designed to deliver B-61 or B-83 nuclear bombs. Target acquisition and engagement were to be handled by the aircraft's sophisticated APQ-181 radar system, which was designed to track multiple objects and engage numerous targets simultaneously. Maintaining the B-2's stealth capabilities required precise environmental control. The aircraft's environmental control system was designed to keep its radar-absorbing materials at optimal conditions, controlling the internal temperature to within 1 degree Fahrenheit and humidity to within 2% across a wide range of external conditions. This system processed over 3,000 pounds of air per minute to maintain the proper environment, ensuring the aircraft's stealth properties would remain intact throughout its mission. Meanwhile, the B-2's landing gear was engineered to support its maximum takeoff weight of 336,500 pounds. Each main gear strut could withstand a load of up to 130,000 pounds. In a nod to the aircraft's stealth requirements, even the tires were filled with nitrogen to prevent moisture-induced damage to the surrounding radar-absorbent materials. In total, the first B-2 contained approximately 65,000 parts and 10,000 sub-assemblies, a testament to its complexity and advanced capabilities. Its projected production cost was approximately $737 million per aircraft in 1997 dollars, making it one of the most expensive aircraft ever conceived. This combination of stealth, range, payload capacity, and advanced systems made the B-2 Spirit a truly unique and formidable concept. The first B-2 was unveiled on November 22, 1988, in a tightly controlled ceremony at Air Force Plant 42. Despite restrictions, Aviation Week magazine managed to capture aerial photographs of the aircraft's secret rear design, publishing them shortly after. AV-1 took to the skies for its maiden flight from Air Force Plant 42 on July 17, 1989. Piloted by Bruce J. Hines and Richard Couch, this historic flight lasted 2 hours and marked the beginning of an intensive testing phase. The testing process quickly uncovered several issues requiring refinement. One of the most significant challenges involved the radar-absorbing materials used in the B-2's skin. These materials proved highly sensitive to environmental conditions, particularly moisture. As a result, engineers developed specialized climate-controlled hangars and intricate maintenance procedures to protect the aircraft's stealth coating. Another major hurdle emerged with the B-2's flying wing design. While offering excellent stealth characteristics, this configuration made the aircraft inherently unstable. Engineers had to extensively refine the fly-by-wire system to ensure the B-2 remained controllable under all flight conditions. This involved numerous software updates and adjustments to the control algorithms. The B-2's engines also presented unexpected challenges. Initial tests revealed that the engine exhaust could potentially compromise the aircraft's stealth characteristics. To address this, engineers redesigned the exhaust system, incorporating special heat-dissipating materials and altering the exhaust flow to minimize its infrared signature. During weapons delivery tests, it became apparent that opening the bomb bay doors could momentarily increase the B-2's radar signature. This led to the development of a rapid opening mechanism and procedures to minimize the time the doors remained open during missions. The aircraft's avionics suite, while advanced, initially struggled with integrating the vast amount of data from various sensors and systems. Software engineers worked tirelessly to improve data fusion and presentation, enhancing the crew's situational awareness. Despite these challenges, the B-2 demonstrated impressive capabilities in terms of range, altitude, and speed. Its stealth characteristics, while the specific details remain classified, were acknowledged to be unprecedented for an aircraft of its size. By the end of the testing phase, the B-2 had undergone numerous modifications and improvements, resulting in an aircraft that met or exceeded many of its original design specifications. On December 17, 1993, Whiteman Air Force Base received its first operational B-2 bomber, dubbed the Spirit of Missouri. After undergoing further evaluation, the B-2 finally entered active service with the United States Air Force in 1997. Its operational debut came 2 years later during 1999 Operation Allied Force, the NATO bombing of Yugoslavia in 1999. This conflict provided the first real-world test of the B-2's capabilities, and the aircraft performed admirably. Flying directly from Missouri to Yugoslavia, the B-2s demonstrated their long-range strike capability, delivering precision-guided munitions with remarkable accuracy. One of the most notable missions during this conflict occurred on May 7, 1999, when a B-2 accidentally bombed the Chinese embassy in Belgrade. While this incident caused significant diplomatic tension, it was attributed to outdated intelligence rather than any fault of the aircraft or its crew. The next major deployment of the B-2 came in the wake of the September 11, 2001 terrorist attacks. As part of Operation Enduring Freedom, B-2s flew some of the longest combat missions in history, striking targets in Afghanistan. These missions, lasting more than 40 hours and requiring multiple in-flight refuelings, showcase the B-2's unparalleled range and endurance. In 2003, during Operation Iraqi Freedom, B-2s were again called into action. Flying from both Whiteman Air Force Base and forward operating locations, they played a crucial role in the opening stages of the conflict, striking high-value targets and helping to disable Iraqi air defenses. The B-2's career, however, has not been without challenges. The aircraft's sensitive stealth coating requires extensive maintenance and climate-controlled hangars. This has led to high operating costs and limited the number of bases from which the B-2 can operate. What's more, in 2008, the B-2 fleet suffered its first and only loss when the Spirit of Kansas crashed shortly after takeoff from Anderson Air Force Base in Guam. Both crew members successfully ejected, but the aircraft was a total loss, reducing the fleet to 20 airframes. Despite these setbacks, the B-2 continued to prove its worth. In 2011, during Operation Odyssey Dawn in Libya, three B-2s flying directly from Missouri successfully struck multiple hardened aircraft shelters at Gardabia Airfield, showcasing the aircraft's ability to conduct precision strikes against well-defended targets. As the B-2 Spirit approaches three decades of service, plans for its future are already well underway. The United States Air Force has announced its intention to retire the B-2 fleet by 2032, replacing it with the new B-21 Raider, currently under development by Northrop Grumman. The B-21, while shrouded in secrecy, is expected to build upon the legacy of the B-2, incorporating advanced stealth technology, improved avionics, and enhanced payload capabilities. It's designed to penetrate even more sophisticated air defense systems that may pose challenges to the B-2 in the coming years. However, until the B-21 is fully operational, the B-2 will continue to receive upgrades to maintain its effectiveness. These include improvements to its communication systems, weapons integration, and defensive systems. One significant upgrade is the Defensive Management System Modernization Program, which will enhance the B-2's ability to detect and avoid enemy air defenses. The legacy of the B-2 Spirit extends far beyond its planned retirement. The technologies developed for the B-2 have influenced countless other aerospace projects, both military and civilian. Its success has cemented the importance of stealth technology in modern warfare and pushed the boundaries of what's possible in aircraft design. As the B-2 Spirit prepares to pass the torch to its successor, it will undoubtedly be remembered as one of the most extraordinary aircraft ever to take to the skies.